Okay. You look familiar. Ah, so you can hear my voice. Welcome to the DigiLab. This place has a faint connection with the digital world, a paradise for Digimon. I am Muriel Ikakura. I open this paradise unto you. Question mark, question mark, question mark. Digital world? DigiLab. The Digital Monster Laboratory. You call it the DML for short, I suppose. I recommend calling it the DigiLab, though. Yeah, I like DigiLab a little more. Digital world? It's okay if you don't know about it, for now at least. When the time comes, I expect you will know that you need to know. I called you. No, that's not quite it. It was you who called to me. No, I'm pretty sure you called me. The reason I'm here is because I was following your voice. Your strange, femininely masculine voice. You're beginning to develop a deep connection with Digimon. Our strings of fate intertwined and drew me in, and so I found you. In other words, it was you who called out to me. Whatever you want to call it, Miss M. But that's enough of that for now. First off, what kind of place is this? Go and check it out with your own eyes. Welcome to the DigiLab. In the DigiLab, you can use a variety of facilities that will help you on your adventure. The DigiBank, Organizer Party, Digivolve, D-Digivolve, and more. Basically, the PC. DigiFarm, raise your Digimon by training or feeding. So the breeding sites. Mirror Dungeon, take on dungeons you have already cleared. Basically, a story repeat. I guess that's good if I need to, redo missions for your leveling up. That helps out. Shop, purchase items for the Digifarm, so basically the Pokemart. Coliseum, Network Battle, I am assuming that's the online system. Yeah, where you can fight with others, because that is a thing here. And then the Medical Machine, recover Digimon HP and SP, just like a Pokemon Center. Man, I like how it makes all those Pokemon references just by talking about each of these features. I truly am a Pokemon nerd, if you can even call it that. But alright, oh, okay, so which one's which again? I probably should have looked at the icons more carefully. Welcome! Please select the transition. Oh, that's a shop, okay. Wait, do I even have any money? I don't see this. 2,338 yen. And I can't even buy anything. Increases EXP for these different attributes of Digimon. I guess it helps me understand, you know, how this works. You got your neutral, dark, light, wind, electric, earth, plant, water, fire. So it's essentially like Zestiria, but with three more elements. You know, plant, electricity, and plant, electricity, and what was it? Neutral. There it is. Yeah, because, you know, dark and light have been a thing with Zillia, but not the previous game. Moving on. So I've already got the basics of that. Okay, the Digimon Bank. I don't have any more Digimon. Digifarm, Digimon Incubator, Digifarm will gain experience within time. Give instructions, okay. Recover for 200... It cost me money to recover my... Wow. Okay. So this isn't like... What happened to free Digimon care? Pokemon care? Ugh, no wonder Pokemon's more popular than you. I kid. But seriously, having to pay for HP? Pokemon doesn't make that a thing, so why is this a thing now? I'm not finished in explaining. Well, you seem like that's me. What else do you have to explain? I'll give you a good explanation of the terminals here, so make sure you remember them all. Yeah, so make sure you can remember them all. I just did, didn't I? I went to the shop, I went here, the Digibank. I talked that, I did that. I guess I haven't done the Coliseum. Participate in Digimon Battle online with players around the country and compete for points. Network battles have the following rules. Cannot battle if your total party memory is more than 150. All the Digimon levels are set to level 50 for the duration of the battle. There are limits set for inputting battle commands and completing the battle. Cool. And this last one over here? The Mirror Dungeon. By using the shortcut gates prepared by Muriel Mikagura, and revisit dungeons you have explored in the past. You can accumulate experience, and there are various methods of use, such as collecting dropped items and Digimon scan data. There we go. Is that it now? Have you understood the DigiLab? Everything here is meant to assist you, so please use them well. Thanks, I will. Assuming I know how to get back here. Do you understand the DigiLab? Use it carefully to further your interactions with Digimon. Let me see if you're the person I thought you might be. Finally, one last thing. A small token for you. Huh? What the? You got a hacking skill! Hacking skills shine in combination with Digimon use, but are dangerous if used for unscrupulous hacking purposes. How you use your skills is up to you. Never forget that. You can deepen your special ties with the Digimon. Live with them, share their joys and sadness, and grow together. By deepening your bond with the Digimon, they'll surely offer you their aid. It is a very important ability. It will never change, it will even change your life. Exclamation points? Connection jump. That's what you call your curious skill. I know nothing of this power. It's like a hacking skill, but... well, different. But certain it's a skill that will serve you in unique ways. I'll see you later. Take care! Yay! See you later. Hacking skills. When on the field, press the square button to open the hacking skill menu. Here you can use the various abilities of your Digimon. To use a skill, the Digimon in the party must meet the necessary conditions. You can check the conditions of a skill from the player device of your Digivice. You're heading to Kowloon, I suspect? Just this once, I'll let you use the special exit. Next time, go to the access point, if you please. Thanks. Oh, that was easy. Access points. Communication devices that use the flow of the digital web. They are reference points for a digital network that connects to locations everywhere. The half-cyber protagonist can use connection jump to move from here to Eden or the DigiLab. Real world can access Eden or the DigiLab, or Eden can only access the DigiLab. Okay, so it's basically, you know, one lets you do whatever, the other is, I guess, a little boss kind of thing. You know, hey, it's time for boss, be ready, and that kind of stuff. Alright. Oh, also these hacking skills. Wall crack. Ooh. Blazes level 1 firewall. Wall crack level 2. For firewall green, red. There's so many of these, and I probably have to increase my level. That probably makes a little more sense. Hacking skill. Wall crack. You can eliminate secure firewalls that block your way and continue your progress. The skill has different levels depending on the resilience of the firewall, and you won't be able to take down a firewall if your wall crack skill level isn't high enough. So I gotta level that up then. But alright! Wall crack! Oh, now I do it. Wall crack! Boop! Break that digital firewall! Word! It's me. Whew, I finally got through to you. I lost your trace info and had to search again. Where did you wander off to this time? I see. So you ran into Mikagura. Yeah, you could say we're acquainted. Regardless, for there to have been a natural progression where you would meet her, you seem to have the craziest luck. Let's assume you carried out your original objective. We'll start by... What? You've already broken through the firewall? Well done. You saved me some time. Alright, on to our next move. I scanned the area around the entrance to Kowloon and marked key junk data sites. Junk data will serve as your body parts. You need to go find and retrieve some. It's something of a stopgap measure, and it may not be a perfect solution, but I'm sure your skills are up to the task. Yeah, maybe. So far, I seem to be level 1, as far as I knew. This is the key steps for turning your body to normal, so buck up and get to work. It's okay, searching for body parts isn't as hard as defeating 48 demons now, is it? I don't know what the reference you're making, but I'm just gonna say yes! Think of it as an emergency measure. I look forward to meeting you in your normal body. Digiline. This is a tool for communicating with people who aren't in the same place. You'll receive messages from your friends and Digimon in your Digifarms. If a notification appears in the bottom right of your screen, click touchpad button or check your receive date messages from the DigiLine menu of your Digivice. You should also reply to your messages when you receive one that needs a reply. Like that. And then just press the touchpad. Did I surprise you? But that's what DigiLine is all about, you know? Let's try using simple phrases you learn from friends and clients. The Digimon on Farms will be ecstatic if you respond to their DigiLine messages. Okay. Please select reply. Got it. Replied. I guess that's it then. Yep, that seems to be it. Wow, and no music whatsoever. Oh, now we get music. Hello? Oh. Okay. Registered a field guide. Scan data of new Digimon will be collected and the Digimon will be registered to the field guide of your device. At the DigiLab, you can digi-convert and browse detailed data by making friends with Digimon through Digivolution and D-Digivolution. So only register detailed data browsing possible. So I can go back to the DigiLab and make friends? That's what I'm getting from this. And I'm just gonna attack. See how much damage we do. Aw, not even a knockout. Boo! I upset. Oh, that was explosive! Whack! And now I get two turns. So I'll just do a regular attack. Go boop! Critical! Okay, so you do get yen as well as EXP from battles. I guess that helps things out. Scan complete for Koromon. Oh, and got the avatar part. One of them, anyway. As for the field guide, let's see, which one was it? Orange. The one we got was this. I think. Isn't that the one we got? Or am I... Oh. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I'll figure this out eventually. I will. Don't you even worry about it. Kowloon level 1. Hey, remember me, buddy? Found more of you of going any further yet. Once you've proven your strength and part as a hacker, the path will open on its own. Man, really? It's a firewall, I could break it easily. I think that's more than worthy enough for beginner standards. Alright, I'll play your game. Skill. Now machine break. Wipe out. Wipe out. Complete. There we go! He actually pumped up there for a second. Skill! Now machine break. Just wipe him out real quick. And then no longer have to worry about him. Are we near the point where we can one-bang these things? Yes, we are! We are more than at that point. And we leveled up as a bonus. 20 HP. Plus one in every other thing, except for the defense where we get the two. Awesome! And Pabumon has been scanned and completed. I'll make sure to check him out at the DigiLab as soon as I can. But for now, moving on. Ooh, treasure! And another avatar part. The first treasure got export! What's the export to? It's the returns party to the dungeon entrance. Oh, it's like... I guess that's in case... I guess it's like an escape rope. In a sense. Then what's the other thing for? Wait, hold on. I can one-bang these guys. At the very least, I can one-bang Poyomon. One-bang! Yeah, I can one-bang him. But definitely not him. He takes two hits. In the event, I'm not too worried. Polymon Metal! Oh, got a notification. Hello? Anyone there? Let's try using simple phrases you learned from your friends and clients. Got it? Such a quick reply. I'm impressed. Guess you get a reply... Guess a reply to reply sometimes. I... guess. I don't know, I'm not too big on the whole texting aspect. I'm not that avid of a texter. Here we go, battle number two. Oh, and we got three of them this time around, of different varieties. Types and attributes. Digimon all have types and attributes, each with their own affinity. A Digimon's type is shown in a mark in the upper left part of all of the stats, and its attribute is displayed by color. During target selection, good affinity is shown with a red target ring, and bad affinity with a blue target ring. That's completely backwards, but okay. Consider affinities when choosing who to attack. There are four attributes, virus, vaccine, data, and free. Attacks from a type with good affinity inflicts double damage, while attacks from a type with bad affinity only inflicts half damage. Oh, I see, I see. So basically, the super effectiveness of your type. Attacks with good attributes inflict 1.5 normal damage. Attacks using skills reflect the attribute of said skill. Yep, and it's pretty basic. Fire, water, and plants does go against each other. Same with earth, electricity, and wind. Okay, that's pretty basic. Actually, that's an interesting cycle. Because usually I'm used to fire, water, and grass, but I guess plant fits that thing so well. And of course, Earth is good against electricity. Electricity is good against flying-type Pokemon, and flying is good... Actually, no, flying is not even close to good against ground Pokemon, but I guess the thing stands to reason. And of course, light and dark are neutral. Okay, then attack. Let's try now, machine break. Let's start off with a Clam. Oh, I get out of attack? Let's finish him off. There we go. Whoa! Double damage. Half damage, apparently. Let's just try regular attack. 0.75. Against him? Double damage. Not bad. Ow. That's also double damage. But now we got three chances. So let me wipe out you real quick. And then using Nano Machine Break, I wipe you out.